My name is John Bungard. I'm an 18-year-old high school student here at Woodstock High School. I did my senior project on music production. I've been in Woodstock school system from kindergarten until 12th grade. In that time being in the school system, I played middle school. I played track and cross country. Also, I'm a 10-year musician playing guitar, bass, and piano. I'm going to attend KSU, where I'll be finishing my undergraduate degree. I'm interested in the medical field and engineering field. My MGRP is on music and how it has caused hearing loss. And my senior project is on music production. This is connected to my MGRP so that many musicians lose their hearing through studio and playing live. And I'll show you the process of making my product, which is the original song composed by myself. First, I'll start with my project facilitator. My project facilitator is Krista Beret. She is a family friend of ours and has helped me with various projects before. First, I'm going to start with December 28th. On December 28th is when I completed my first original score of my song. I did it on Muse composition software. I wanted to use an original score sheet so I can add or discard changes along the way for recording. And before that, I did vocal lessons to get my voice ready for recording vocals, obviously. And also, I looked at a frequency chart to show which instruments record best at which frequencies and pitches. Now, on February 17th, this is where I started to record my first guitar track. For this track, I used a condenser mic, which was used in front of my acoustic guitar. I also played almost 140 beats per minute click track. I used a click track to make sure that I was on time throughout the song. And so having a click track made it easier to record bass tracks and other lead tracks, so it'd also be on time as I was recording. Next is February 17th. On February 22nd, this is where I recorded my bass tracks and guitar tracks. For the bass tracks, I used a Pro Tune software, which was done on a keyboard. This is where it enabled me to play the bass on a keyboard, so I can control the velocity and pitch of each note I was playing. Also, I used guitar. This is when I recorded the guitar tracks. Guitar tracks are done on a lower octave and a higher octave on my guitar. The click track kept me on time as I did these tracks. First, I did a lower octave first, and then a higher octave. This is a method known as layering, so it gives the song a more fuller sound. Now, on March 7th. March 7th is when I finished my main vocal tracks. Also finished all my other guitar and bass tracks. Prior to this event, I came up with a complication of losing all my vocal tracks that were recorded in the loop. So to overcome this, I had to record all my vocal tracks in one single perfect take. So this is a bit difficult, but I was able to get through it, and it helped me along the way. Also, me and my facilitator finished up all the mastering and mixing for my song, enabling me to fix any difficulties with notes in my bass tracks and add reverb or any other effects so you get the song a more fuller sound. Now I'll show you my completed song. So you can tell in the first part of the song, I used the double layering of each lead guitar track. And then now I added a reverb on my vocals. So now in this chorus, I have reverb along with my vocals, and it's just the same old bass layer guitar track and the bass track. So then I come back in with the two guitar lead tracks, and then it's going to have vocals coming over this track. And so in this part, we thought it'd be a good idea to have the song stop and just come back into the chorus unexpectedly. So it gives the listeners a little more of an attention grabber. And so it gives out the rest of the song, finishing the chorus. Alright. So this project, I've learned a lot in recording and how it's a great experience. It was a learning stretch to me because prior to this, I have been recorded, but I've never had the opportunity to record myself or someone else. So I never knew how to really work mics and how to really mix and fix songs up and make it sound as good as they do now. Also, this enabled me to learn the writing process and songwriting. So how I can create a catchy hook and a good chorus that will mix up a good popular song. From this experience, I've learned that it can help me further on educational or workplace goals. So from there, I learned that if you want to have a professional product, that you have to work through any difficulties throughout the process. So you have to have a backup plan, research before, and always know what you can do if the situations come up in a bad situation. So, also, I don't want to go in this field as I move on. I want to go to the medical field, as mentioned, or the engineering field. Music will always be a part of my life, and it's always a great hobby to have. And thank you for your time, and have any questions.